Hi guys, Phill Dale from Skarnsundet Fjord Centre here. Doing a bit of lure fishing today. Predominantly really we're going to fish for pollock and cod. This is really because we're almost at low water. We're about an hour away from low water. So we're just fishing in Skarnsundet. We're just 200 metres away from the bridge leg. And we really picked this place today because of the low water conditions that we have. Whether you've maybe seen in previous videos that we've filmed here, we're actually fishing a ledge. So we're trying to fish between kind of 20 and 30 meters deep. We're using the 23 gram black minnow and the Tenor IU super mix rod with a 5,000 style fixed reel. Quite light braid, it's like 18 pound braid. It's kind of standard for what I use really. I never use anything much heavier, especially when I'm doing light lure fishing around here. So yeah, it's a lovely day. It's 11 o'clock, low water's in about an hour and a half. But I can see it's come pretty much slack already. So what really I want to do is I just want to spend an hour on this mark, and then I'm going to go over to the other side of Skarnsundet, and we're going to fish there for an hour as well. So I'm just going to try and sneak a couple of marks in just before the low water period to see if we can learn a little bit more about this, about the pollock fishing in Skarnsundet. The last time I fished here, it was high water, or it was just before high water, and there was a lot of current. But the majority of the fish that we caught, they came when there was a lot of current, which I always prefer to fish when there is less current, really. Gives the shad more time to work in certain places and you get a little bit slower drift. Few fish on the bottom here. You see, we're just fishing up. If you can see behind me, you see a big cliff that just continues all the way down till it's about 150 meters deep, and that's literally the middle of Skarnsundet. So that's a rocky ledge pretty much all the way down. But when we fish here, we generally fish between like 15 and probably 30, 35 meters deep. That's where we see most of our fish sitting on the side of the ledges. So there's several ways to fish it. The two most common techniques are, I'll show you. What you do is we're at 24 meters deep now. So all we do is we just cast back there, 10 or 20 yards back. And we'll let the lure get down. We want the lure on the bottom to begin with. It's probably about 10, 12 meters deep there. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna just reel the shad off the ledge. So it's going like that down, and then we're gonna reel towards us, and hopefully it'll just drop that shad down the side of the ledge. So there's the bottom. And just reel very slowly, maybe 5 or 6 meters, then stop again and wind. And that lure's just finding its way down that ledge now. You'll get most of the strikes you get is when you're winding real slow. Really nice light lure way of fishing. We drifted in a little bit too much. Get that down to the bottom. If you can imagine them pollock, they're just sat on the side of the ledges. 22 metres deep now. So the ledge will be 22 metres deep, kind of parallel with the shoreline all the way. So the other way you can fish this as well is you can cast parallel with the shoreline. And then what you're doing, instead of letting the lure come down, you're lifting it, you're fishing it along the side of the ledge. It can be also really effective as well. Especially if you're drifting over the fish fast and your drift lines are quite straight, you know where the boat's going to go, so then you can get in front of it all the time, kind of counteracting the drift. So we let that get down, there's the bottom, and we just start to wind real slowly. And obviously as it's coming up to the boat, it's becoming becoming shallower and shallower. That was a bite. Find the bottom again, let it naturally sink down, and then just start to wind again. Oh. A few takes then, I think they must be just plucking the end of it. Could be small fish as well, not necessarily a big pollock. It's really the right time of year to get a big pollock now though. Yeah, we're still on 24 here, so we'll just cast a little bit further left, slightly deeper, and then just repeat that technique again. So that's come slightly out towards the middle of the fjord there. And that's probably put us in about 27 to 28 metres deep. There's certainly fish there. It's a really interesting way of lure fishing. Especially for pollock. Oh, the fish took it on the drop. Oh! It took it, but it didn't stay. Oh. Certainly works, this technique, though. We'll get him again. Wasn't a big fish, but I always prefer to be casting away from the boat really, rather than vertical fishing. I think sometimes, especially over shallow water, it's you're not disturbing the fish, so you're fishing on fish that don't know there's a boat there. Whereas if you're on shallow, if you're on shallow ground and you're just vertical fishing underneath the boat, if there's a lot of people on and you're quite noisy, you have like a scare zone around the boat, and the best way to counteract that is to cast away. Especially on pollock, they are quite sensitive to that. I've noticed it with place fishing over shallow waters as well, is that it can be really beneficial to cast out of that scare zone. It's almost like uptiding. So that hit the bottom there, And I would think it was probably 23, 24 metres deep. I just stop, let it get down to the bottom again. In these cold conditions, I don't see much fish in midwater. Apart from the coal fish that are pretty much always in midwater. We're drifting in a little bit, so this is my last cast on here. And we'll just go out and up a little bit. We'll go out another 10-20 metres and get back into that depth zone where we want to be fishing. Small fish. See if we can find something a bit bigger. Probably a small codling. We've gone to 15 metres deep now, it's a bit shallow here. Okay, let's get us back out and we just changed our technique a little bit now. And we've come off the pollock because it went dead slack water. So what we're doing now is we've come just to an island, just 10 minutes away from where we were, about 15 minutes from Skarnsundet. And we're just casting towards the shore and retrieving the lures back again. Just literally hopping them or dragging them over the bottom. We've just come into a little bay near the island. It's kind of a traditional spawning place for cod and haddock here. I thought it might be a little bit too early to be fishing here because of the season, not because of the tides. But I've just done my second cast now and a nice cod. Nice for me anyhow. And that's it's a really nice way to catch cod. Show you him. Okay. First, really nice way to catch cod. I'll show you the technique next. Just hooked up to the jaw there. It's well hooked. Yeah. Nice little stamp of cod. Codling. Fantastic condition. Let's get him slipped back. So all we're doing is we take the lure, and there's the shoreline. It's 19 metres deep here. Let's cast towards the shoreline. We're probably 10, 12 metres deep there. And then all we do is sink and draw the lure back towards the boat. Very easy technique. And again, gets us out of that scare zone. And gives us the ability to fish other ground. There's the bottom, then you just flick it up a few winds and then let it sink down to the bottom itself. So now that lure is just on the way down to the bottom very slowly. And of course, the further we are away from the boat, from the shore, sorry, the deeper it gets. So you're just fishing ledges really. And you can kind of do this technique anywhere. I prefer it in this quiet bay because it is a traditional spawning ground. But I think we might be a bit too early. Probably another couple of weeks and they've made their way into here. But you can pick any type of shoreline as long as it's steep. It needs to be quite steep or it doesn't work very well. And it needs to be around 10 to 20, that type of depth. And then as we're pulling that shad towards us, obviously it's just getting deeper and deeper. You just flick it up and then let the lure work its way back down again. We had another drop on another pollock mark, but there was nothing there. You could see them on the sonar, but they weren't feeding. A couple of really light plucks, like the ones I missed in the beginning. And that's why we headed up here, really. So that's the end of that one. So all I do is reel it back in. And cast towards the shore again. Kind of a good thing to do is, if you don't hook a fish on that one, just move 10 or 15 yards to the right of it or to the left of it. Because, you know, these fish are shoaled up quite tightly, so they can be, we can be just off them there, but on them here. So unless you catch a fish on that particular run through, and then you just want to kind of repeat a similar area again, because they're shoaled up tightly together, so then you know you're kind of on them. So if you've got a few guys fishing like this off the boat, they all want to be fishing different directions, really. And then you'll see one side of the boat here or there, they'll start catching the fish, then you know they're in that particular area. Another good tip is, if you watch the rod, you'll see it when it settles. There, that's the bottom there. And then you can just leave it a couple of seconds. Sometimes they'll just come and take it as it's laid on the bottom, especially if they've been following it. Beautiful day. That's all it needs, a quick flick with the tip. I never lower the rod. I always keep the rod in this position. It's kind of what I like to call strike position. So when I get a strike, I can hook it. Now we're almost back to the boat again now. I don't see anything on the sonar underneath us, so I don't bother vertically fishing. I'll just reel in and cast again. You get 90% of your takes as the lure's dropping through the water. So the reason you don't move your tip is because you don't want to increase the speed of how you drop it. The speed it's dropping. You want to make that as slow as possible, really. Hey, on another note though, Valentine's Day yesterday. So took our lass to a seafood restaurant last night. Beautiful place. Anyhow, we gets in there, waiter come services. You're very nice. Got a very nice table, sir. Thank you very much. So sits our lass down and he comes over and he says, what would you like? What would you like? And our lass says, I'll have a fish platter. He says, fantastic. Brilliant. We have the freshest fish. So he says, what would you like, sir? I said, I'll have a lobster. Feeling a bit flush. I'll have a lobster. It's fantastic. So I'll be 10 minutes, have it over. Anyhow, have a bit of a drink. 10 minutes later, our lass's fish platter comes up. Gorgeous. Fish, shrimps, everything. And he brings my lobster over. He says, got your lobster, sir. I said, it's only got one claw. And he says, it's been in a fight. I said, well, give me the winner. Give me the winner. Because he had three claws with the winner. Tommy Cooper job. Fantastic. So we'll just take another cast in that direction now. And then if we don't have a hook up on that cast, we'll just move along. Just move along the shore. You know, 50 yards is enough, and then repeat the same system again. The important thing is when you are doing this, is not to drive too close to the shore. Because if you drive too close to the shore, you'll disturb them. Because these cod are in relatively shallow ground. So you don't want to be motoring over them with a boat and scaring them. You want to come from the depth and cast towards the shore. Just try not to disturb them so much. It's a good way of increasing your catch rates. We'll see what happens on this one. If we don't have anything, we'll just move on. There's plenty of shorelines to explore. Just trying to get the rod in on the camera so you can see it. Hardly any drift. That's it, it's just about to start flooding. So we got low water down on the pollock marks, no pollock. But what we'll do is we'll fish around this area for a couple of hours and we'll let the flood build up and then we'll go back and we'll go and try for a pollock again. You get really hard takes as well when you fish like this. And you only need to fish light. This is a 40 gram head. If you're fishing even shallower waters, you can use 20, 25, 30 gram heads. The lighter the better, really. The lighter the lure is, the slower it'll fall through the water. There's another reef just up here as well, just 5 minutes up where I just want to try as well. We used to catch a lot of halibut there. I've brought a heavier jig with me. I might just have a drift over that ground with a, just let a couple of rods down and just drift over it with the shads on. It's always nice to be trying new places. And a bit deep, we're just drifting out from the shore now. No, nothing on that now. So we'll move up about 50, 60 yards and we'll just have another few more casts towards the shore. See what happens there, see if we can find a shoal of nothing. Nice fish. I think it's a pollock. I'm just winding my shads in real slow, casting towards the shore again. But on my brown house mark, which is predominant pollock mark really. It's gone. There it's gone. That must, fish must have been in mid-water. That's gone. Probably 30 yards from the shore. Just fishing for pollock. Yeah, I cast it towards the shore. Slowly winding in. Come a bit closer to the shore now. Back out a little bit. Kind of drifting parallel, so that's nice. And a little bit, we're only like 30, 40 yards off. It's a little bit too much, a little bit too close. Gram head I'm using on the fish minnow. I think it's a size 4. I'll have a look. Nice though, we've got out of the wind. We've had a few fish up there, but not of any size. So now we're just going to drift past what's known as the Brown House. It's kind of a very steep cliff right in front of me. Again, casting towards the shore and reeling really slowly back. How we typically fish for pollock. As the shad's coming towards me, it's just drifting down the ledge slowly. And reeling in, you know, as slow as kind of this speed is really. But there's a real lack of pollock. Oh, there's quite a... There's some below me now. They're just on the ledge. It's really exciting way to fish. Hey, do you know what donkeys get in Blackpool for their dinner? 15 minutes. Donkey rides. Fantastic. Coming a bit close in again. On the sonar, I'm not sure it's pollock, it looks like there's quite a lot. We'll just fish this one last drift through. And then we'll move on down to the bridge and then I think we're going to call it a day. It's like 2:15. It's lovely though, sun's shining, the wind's dropped off. It's about 10 yards short of the shoreline there. Just let it hit the bottom. The bottom. And then just reel in slow. Such a simple technique. Might just continue on actually. Looks quite nice for the next 100 metres or so. Kind of really steep down. Caught a lot of pollock from here in the past. But it's always the same when you want to make a film, it's always difficult. Really well these fish minnows actually with this light rod. Nice to use. This used to be the kind of prime spot. We're just coming up on the house now. And it's like sheer cliff faces right in front of me. Could be the season as well. Could be a bit deeper. Used to fish here a lot in spring. It's nice for sea trout as well, especially on an evening. These boats, they drift really well. They haven't got a cabin on them or anything. They seem to drift quite straight. I have another boat that has a cabin on. It always seems to sit funny into the drift. But not these ones. I much prefer fishing off a boat like this without the cabin. Especially when we're doing this type of fishing. Let it touch the bottom. Yeah, especially on an evening, spring, April, late March, April, May. You can catch them like this as well. We're using like really small Dexter wedges or small spoons. Oh, there's one. Just felt him plucking the tail. That's funny, that fish, that's a pollock, and that fish followed it. You could feel it plucking the tail of it. At least I think it's a pollock. There's like two bites. It's only a small one. Might not be a pollock. Yeah, it's a little pollock. Tiny pollock. Feel it, just like nip nip. Oh, very small pollock here. On its grandmother, really. You see it on the sun, it's just gone straight back in again. But I didn't stop really when I felt the bite. Just carried on slowly. Usually if you stop reeling when you feel the bites, they just shy off, they won't follow it anymore. And then some you get, they just bang, they just really take it hard. Others, they're really delicate. I'm always a bit too keen, I'm always like that, striking. Striking at nothing. Well, at least it was a target achieved. The exact size we want, but I can't see what you want. Like. A bit close to the shore, though. Just going to continue drifting. Looks like we're just going across like a bit of a beachy part now. What's the bottom? Just coming across a bit of a beachy part, so it gets a bit shallower, and then it has like another 100 metres of cliffs. Which is usually the area where you really want to be, somewhere really steep edges. Pollock has sat in there, sat in the old rocks that have fallen down the cliff. There's the bottom. Yeah, I think we'll just move on to the next area. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed that short film. Just a Sunday afternoon out on the boat, really. Nothing special, few cod. that small pollock, missed a few fish, but enjoyable few hours fishing. Hope you're kind of trying to build up a picture of what I'm trying to do really with these short films, just give you help and advice on how to fish in fjord situations when you're specifically coming to Skarnsundet, but also other places in Norway. All these techniques work, and I'm sure they'll work back in the UK as well. A little bit murkier water some places, so the shad fishing might not be so so effective there. But I'm going to continue with a pollock fishing, because there's so many more different marks to try. To try and build up more of a picture of how it is and the particular areas to fish where the pollock are lying in Skarnsundet. So stay tuned. Thanks.